Hello everyone, this is Satvik here, and in this video we'll discuss about a cool MITM framework which helps us in performing various cool tasks. So without getting any delay, let's dive into the video. So guys, if you are watching my channel for the first time, make sure you subscribe and like this video, and also do check out my other videos as well in different playlists, and if you really like them, share with your friends as well. And also guys, if you need any kind of support, check out my Discord server. All the links are in the description below. So let's dive into the video. So guys, if you are not familiar with MITM, I will provide you a URL, okay, a web page which provides you complete information regarding MITM. So I'll quickly brief it. So MITM is like we are spoofing the guy. So suppose if you want to attack the target, so what you try to do is you try to say that we are access point, which is like router to the target, and we are spoofing the router that we are that particular target. So what ultimately we are doing is we are trying to capture all the data that target is sending. Okay, so this is the basic thing that is going to do. So we'll look into that. And also, if you want to know more information about MITM, there are various MITM attacks. I'll provide you the link for the web page in the description below. So guys, the framework we are going to discuss today is called as Zerosploit. So Zerosploit is a cool framework that works on top of BetterCap and EtherCap. So if you are familiar with MITM attacks, so you would be familiar with what is BetterCap and EtherCap. So those are the popular MITM tools which helps us in performing various attacks, okay, like sniffing the data, capturing the credentials and stuff. So Zerosploit works on them guys, above them. So you can see it is powered by BetterCap and Nmap, so it is not related to EtherCap, sorry, but both BetterCap and EtherCap are of similar type. Okay, so BetterCap is like GUI version and EtherCap is like GUI version, BetterCap is like command line version. Okay, so you can see this is the git repo of that particular tool. So we'll try to install this case, and installation is pretty simple. You can find out the steps within the tool itself, okay, sorry, the repository itself. So you can open the terminal out there, and I had already downloaded it guys because it's going to take a little bit of time, so I'm going to enlarge it a little bit. So the things are really simple. You need to clone that first of all. Since I had already have them, so it is not going to take much time for me. So it is saying already it is available. If not for you, it will take some time to install this thing. And you need to do the thing, okay? So you need to navigate to that Zerosploit directory, and you need to install this thing, okay? So it is going to install all the requirements. So if you run this command, you can get something like it is asking us to choose an operating system. Since I'm on Kali Linux, I'm using one, so you can feel free to use any kind of distribution guys. It is completely of your choice. There is no particular recommendation to use anything like that. So it is going to install some stuff. Since I already had this tool, it is not going to take much time for me, but if not, it is going to take some time. So make sure you are having a little bit of patience. And also guys, if you are having any issues regarding the tool, so you can navigate to this repo, and here you can, in the issues section, you can find out various issues that the users are facing, and there are also good support to those, like there has been good solution for them as well. So you can do check them out if you are facing much issues. So we'll close this thing up, and it is going to take some time, but since, as I told you, I had already have them, so it is not going to take much time. So it will install some requirements guys, and after that you can see that you don't need to navigate to this Zerosploit directory all the time. You can run this Zerosploit command anywhere in the terminal, okay? So it works well, like it is like it will become like a nmap or anything like that, okay? You can simply paste the command. Also guys, if you are not a root user, make sure you have sudo command before all these commands, okay? So if you can see, I got it with issues. So for the first time while I was installing, I got some issues guys, so make sure you solve them. Suppose if there are any import errors, make sure you do some pip install and that import. Okay, so it is going to take some time. Okay, this is not like a normal tool. So if you're having any issues and if you're unable to sort it, do contact me over my Discord server and help them there. Okay, so if you run this command, you can see some cool stuff, guys, like who is the author and stuff. And it is also showing the IP address, the MAC address of our particular machine. So the host name, interface and stuff. So the first and the foremost thing and the best thing is help. So if you type help, guys, for the first time, you can see some things like you can scan the network, you can set the interface. Suppose let's think I am on Ethernet over there. So you can connect to your Wi-Fi adapter and you can choose your iface over there, like interface over there. You can set your gateway. Okay, you can start and doing stuff, various stuff out there. Okay, so the first and the best thing is you always need to scan whole the network so that you can find out some IPs over there. And also, guys, I have my Ubuntu running over there, so with an IP address of 192.168.15.129. So this is my target right now. Okay, so let me navigate back to my Kali machine. So this here, you can see all the devices that are available in this network. So I'm going to copy the IP of your target stuff and simply paste it over there and simply hit enter. So it is going to choose it. And also, guys, for everything there is a clear explanation like what to do. Suppose you can choose the target by simply providing the IP, and you can also see a verbose like this particular machine has been the targeted. Okay, so it is asking us to load some modules. Okay, so modules are like, suppose if you take a BetterCap, you also have some various modules over there, and even this tool has some various modules. So you can simply type help over here to see various modules, and the cool part comes here. You can see some various modules over there. You can do port scan, and you can also do some various cool attacks, like you can play a background music, okay, of YouTube. You can do a DNS spoof. Okay, you can sniff the target, you can replace the downloaded file. Let's think he's downloading an exe. You can replace that with your exe of malicious type. You can inject the JavaScript. Okay, you can inject the HTML code. Okay, you can ping it, you can ping any machine. You can do DOS attack as well, but I don't know how effective it is. But mostly my Ubuntu machine won't allow this because it's having a firewall built in. And also something like view images requested by the target, the driftnet command. So if you are if the target is looking for any images, it is going to gather all those images. And one more cool thing is you can also shake the web browser content. You can write the web pages with your own HTML code. You can replace the web page images with your own one. So enough explanation, we'll dive into it. So the first and the foremost thing we'll do is we'll look into a replace command. So you can simply type replace over here, simply hit enter, and in order to run the module, you can simply type run, and it is asking us to insert the path. So I'm having an image over there, a Luke Skywalker's image. Let me go to the properties, let me copy this thing, let me paste it there. And also, guys, tab doesn't work here. Okay, the tab doesn't work here. So that's the reason I'm copying the path and the file names. Okay, so let me paste the whole path. So I think I had done some mistake. Okay, the image that I had provided is not defined. So I'll do once again. The reason is I haven't copied the correct path, guys. Okay, so I need to look into that. Just a minute. 168.15.129. Okay, so this is my target over there, and let me look into help once again to look into the modules, and I'm going to type a replace command over there. Okay, so I'm going to go back to Satvik directory. I'm looking to the properties over there. Okay, so I think by mistake I had deleted some stuff. That's fine. And I'm also going to copy this file name. Okay, so it is absolutely fine right now. Let me hit enter. sorry, I need to type the run over there, and now I need to provide the location. Let me copy this, let me paste it, and you can see it is going to run. So all the images will be replaced by this particular image. So now let's go back to our target machine and let's load back. So guys, back it was all in hurry. Okay, I was on hurry, so I did some mistakes, but make sure you are having a little bit of consciousness while doing this thing. So I'm going to load a testphp.oneweb website, which is by Acunetix, and you can see that all these images in all these images get replaced by this. And also one important thing, guys, one important thing that you need to remember is most of these attacks work only on HTTP. You can do all these on HTTPS, and also if the person is using HTTP plus VPN connection, even then you can do these kinds of things. Okay, so it is better for you to test them on the HTTP websites, and you can do some various things, like you can downgrade the HTTP and HTTPS using other tool, and you can try out all these attacks on them. So now let me come back. So you can see that we got the attack, we got the same image. So you can go to your profile. Okay, so wherever the image is there, it is going to be like that only. So you can get the same image. So I'm going to stop this module, guys. So for that, hit Control C over there, and it is going to stop that particular MITM attack. So we are right now in the replace module. So you can simply come back, and you can type once again help to view all the modules out there. Okay, so and one more thing we can try out is move. So move is like it going to shake the web content. Okay, so that is cool, that's kind of cool. Let me show you that. You can simply type run to run that. Let me go back to my target machine. Let me reload the page once again. So you can see it is shaking like anything. Okay, so I'm not doing anything. The module is making the web page shake. Okay, so you can go back to our machine, and you can simply hit Control C so that this particular module stops. Okay, and you can come back and you can see some more things, like you can play a YouTube video. I'm not going to play that, so you can simply do that by wipe play. Okay, and if you simply hit run, it is asking you to insert some YouTube ID. So if you go and look into YouTube, so if you go something like this, if you go to a particular YouTube video, there is going to be some ID, guys. So copy that ID and pay and provide that to the tool. Okay, so that it is going to play. For now, I'm coming back. Okay, so try out all these things, and you can also do some DNS spoofing attacks. So you can provide a specified IP so that all the requests come to that particular IP, DOS, ping, and various things like that. Okay, and most of them I can say that they'll work all the time. Okay, so you can see some of them working. So you can do something like sniff over there. Okay, and you can simply do run. And if you want to load SSL strip, you can load it. So SSL strip is going to view the HTTPS content. Okay, so it is going to start this thing. So you can see everything is going to be saved in a pcap file here. Okay, so you can look for that. So let's wait for some time, and if you got whatever you need, you can simply hit Control C over there, and you can also save the logs, or else you can simply hit no. Okay, the logs has been removed. So now you can navigate to OPT directory, zero exploit. Okay, and then here you can see into zero sniff. There you can look for that. I had removed the lock, so there won't be any lock. So if you hit Y there, so it is going to have that particular log over there, like the pcap file and stuff. And guys, there are some various things you can try for. You can do a port scan. Okay, you can do a port scan. Sorry, let me come back. You can do port scan, you can do a run over there. So all 1000 ports are closed. Okay, so it, as I told you, it is having something like a firewall, so it is not going to show up various things over there. So this is everything, guys, and you can also try inject.js. Let me come back. So you can simply do run over there. And also, guys, I'm having a JS file over there on my home directory, which is test.js. So it is nothing but it throws up a pop-up called as alert, hello, you are hacked. So let me show that. test.root/test.js. So now let me go back to my browser and let me reload this thing. You can see that we are getting a pop-up, hello, you are hacked. That's fine. So that's it, guys. That's it for regarding this tool. You can try out some various modules out there that are available. Okay, so it's absolutely your choice. Okay, you can do some various kinds of stuff. So that's it, guys, for this video and for this tool. And I hope you really find this tool helpful. And if you like this video, make sure you like it and do subscribe to my channel, and also share this video with your friends who are really interested in doing these things. So this is everything for this video, guys. Thank you for watching this video. This is Satvik signing off, and I'll meet you in the next video.